Do you feel dejected, dismayed, dispirited, depressed, demoralized, and disappointed? Do you feel abandoned and lonely? Do you feel worthless? Do you feel broken in all arenas and spheres of life? And it appears tomorrow hangs on a horizon full of bleakness, with your life shrouded in disarray, controlled by a pendulum of uncertainty. Then this audio was made with you in mind. If you do not feel any of these things we have spoken about, then you need to listen to this even more. I believe that we all enjoy our last audio entitled Stay Provoked, which did quite well in Ghana and beyond. Much thanks goes to you, my lovely listeners, for giving me the audience and sharing the Aspect audios with others. Special mention is made of Dynamic Studios in Temanu Town for producing the audios, and to KSO Creations in Kumasi for producing the only video we have in our closet. We want to make acknowledgement to Mrs. Seth J and to Nanamu Akun for helping the audio to come to birth. The current audio is entitled The Value of Life. My name is Aspect Obimpe Frimpong. You can call me the narrator. You can reach me on phone on +233 24 88 11 138. I'm from Ghana. Presently, the most intriguing question that ought to be answered is, what is the value of life? A young man once asked his father the same question. The father, bent on making a lasting impression on his son, decided to use a more practical approach to give him an answer. The father gave his son a piece of rock and told him, take this piece of rock to the market. If you go and anybody wants to buy it, don't say anything. Just put up your two fingers. So the boy took the piece of rock to the market, and a woman wanted to buy it and said, young man, I want to buy your rock. I want to put it in my garden. How much is it? The boy did not say anything. He just put up his two fingers. And the woman said, I'll take that for 200 Ghana cedis. The boy excused the woman and went home and told his father. The father said, I am sending you again. Take the same piece of rock to the museum. If you go and anybody wants to buy it, don't say anything. Just put up your two fingers. The boy took the rock to the museum, and a man immediately wanted to buy it. The boy did not say anything. He just put up his two fingers. And the man said, I'll take that for 2,000 Ghana cedis. The boy excused the man and went home with shock and disbelief in his eyes, and told his father what had transpired. The father told him, take the rock to the final place, to a precious mineral store. If you go and anybody wants to buy it, you already know what to do. As soon as the boy got to the precious mineral store, the owner of the store wanted to buy the rock and said, young man, this is one of the rarest pieces of rocks around. I must have it at all cost. How much is it? The boy did not say anything. He just put up his two fingers. And the museum owner said, I'll take that for 20,000 Ghana cedis. The boy, unable to control himself, ran from the presence of the man to his father. Incredible. The same piece of rock at different prices depending on where it was taken. From 200 Ghana cedis in the market, to 2,000 Ghana cedis in the museum, to 20,000 Ghana cedis in the precious mineral store. The same can be said for life. We as human beings are valuable depending on where we place ourselves. If you place yourself at a higher pedestal, you'll be valuable. But if you place yourself at a lower pedestal, obviously your value will diminish. Apart from that innate feeling, we also need to work physically to maintain a valuable life. As we listen to this audio, someone might be so down. Someone might even be planning to take their own life because the person has failed to connect to the fact that the value of his life is not determined by the heftiness of the atrocities that befall him. It doesn't matter if you are sick and at the point of death, your life is worth more. It doesn't matter if everybody has shunned your company, your life is worth more. It doesn't matter how many times you have failed, your life is worth more. Nobody sees the good in you, and so what? Your life is worth more. There seems to be no door out of your current predicament. Your life is indeed worth more. The components, ingredients, and recipe for a valuable life rest with you. Never believe that the value and worth of your life is solely controlled by peripheral activities. The Master Brewer is a poem that can help us to understand what we are talking about even better. Stanzas 1 and 2 says, there is a distillery in our brains. It malt and canes, It hops and grains are the stuff our lives are made up of. Blizzard or snow, bushfire or drought, matches won by penalty shootout, fortunes lost at the toss of a coin. Over these and their likes, you are no doing. The final stanza is even better. It says, the master brewer is not the stars nor yet the gods. He is you, your very self. The final brew has no choice. It must be bitter bile or sweet honey. We can deduce from the poem that everybody is a brewer making their own drinks. The kind of taste that comes out of the drinks depends on the ingredients and preparation method. Our life is like the brew. Whether our life will be a bitter bile or sweet honey depends on your inputs. Wrapping up, the story is told of a frog that was put into water and placed on fire. As the temperature of the water started changing, the frog started changing its own temperature to meet the change in the water temperature. It kept doing this until the water reached boiling point. At this level, the frog could not adapt to the change and tried to jump, but it was too late and it died. Many people think the frog died because of the heat from the boiling water. No, there is a more subtle reason responsible for the death of the frog. As soon as the frog started changing its temperature to meet that of its surroundings, it used energy to do that. It kept using the energy to adapt to the change until it got weak and could not jump out. Life requires that sometimes you have to be swift about some decisions. Other times you must be diplomatic about things. There are times you must take the bull by the horn. Other times you must be very tactful to get the best out of life. When you are torn between a hard place and a rock, always remember that your life has a value, and this value is absolute and unaffected until you doctor it yourself. May the season bring you joy. May it help you to appreciate the beautiful soul that you are. Always remember, your life is valuable. Please don't forget to listen and pass on to others. You may be the pigment they may be lacking to hold your life in a high esteem. There is another audio on circulation entitled, What If Tomorrow Never Comes? Do enjoy that one too and share. Thank you for your audience.